Welcome to the Power and Energy Society General Meeting. I am Paulo Guedes-Pinot, Vice President of Technology at Infinitum Electric, and today I'm going to talk about our high-efficiency axial flux permanent magnet machines. In today's presentation, I'm going to provide an overview of our technology. I'm going to share some preliminary test results of prototypes that we built and tested in the past 2 years. We're going to explore some of the potential applications for our technology and share with you the next steps in our product development roadmap. Starting with the motor, this is a typical cross-section of our axial flux permanent magnet machine. You can see the stator. You can see the two rotor discs. Being this an air core machine, you need two rotor discs to be able to establish the magnetic circuit. And the rotor carries the magnets that establish the magnetic field, and the magnets face each other with the stator in between. Now let's talk a little bit about the stator. The stator is the most distinguishing feature of our technology. This picture shows two stators. Both of them are rated 1/3 of a horsepower, and they operate in machines that run at 1800 RPM. The one on the right came from a conventional induction motor. The one on the left is a PCB stator used in Infinitum Electric axial flux machines. The stator is a multi-layer PCB where coils are etched on the various layers. I'm highlighting here one of the coils. They are all interconnected by means of electric vias. I'm highlighting one of them. And the striking difference between these two stators is the weight. The stator on the left weighs about 1/10 of the weight of the one on the right. That's for the same power rating. Infinitum Electric has developed a unique technology around PCB stators. It has 13 patents issued so far, and many others in the process of being evaluated. And that differentiates our design from all other electric machines. Let's continue to explore the differences between the two technologies. On a conventional iron core machine, we have core losses, which are a combination of eddy current losses and hysteretic losses. These losses are present all the time, regardless of the load condition of the machine. Whether it is running a full load or partial load, core losses are there all the time. On an air core machine, there is no core, therefore there are no losses. On a conventional iron core machine, we do see eddy current losses in the rotor. That's the main reason why induction motors have a laminated rotor with the purpose of mitigating those eddy current losses. On a permanent magnet machine, this is a particular insidious problem as eddy current losses happen inside the magnets themselves. These eddy current losses on the rotor are caused by variation of the magnetic field across the air gap. On an air core axial flux machine, the magnetic flux as seen by the rotor and its magnets is constant, so there are no eddy current losses induced in the rotor. The presence of core losses contribute to the low efficiency in light load conditions in conventional machines. As conventional machines operate at light load, the core losses become a substantial fraction of the total power coming into the machine, and therefore that affects the efficiency in light load. On an air core machine, there's no core losses, so the efficiency is high in pretty much all load conditions. Only in very, very light load, where the mechanical losses become a substantial portion of the power going into the machine, if we start seeing degradation in the efficiency. Another difference between the two technologies: on a conventional iron core machine, there are magnetic forces between rotor and stator. These forces can cause cogging torque and magnetic noise. On an air core machine, there is no magnetic force between rotor and stator, so there's no cogging torque, and these machines tend to run much quieter than their conventional iron core brethen. Another difference, in a conventional machine, the heat generated by the current in the copper coils usually has to go from the coils to the core and then from the core to the surrounding air. That limits the current that can be pushed through the coils. On an air core machine, as you saw in a previous slide, the coils are directly exposed to the cooling air inside the machine. So it's not unusual to have stators where the current density is up to 3 times higher than on conventional machines. And this is another contributing factor to the reduced size of the stator. Another aspect that I like to highlight, the manufacturing process for conventional machines is labor intensive, is a manual process. Coils need to be inserted inside the slots. They need to be tied together, need to be connected, and the whole stator usually goes through a impregnation process. On an air core machine, the stator is a PCB. So it's made on the automated equipment, the same equipment that makes PCBs for electronics. It's a very repeatable process, consistent quality, doesn't depend on operator skill. We can have stators made by two different vendors and they could look identical. As I mentioned before, another advantage of air core machines is the lightweight of the stator, which is typically 1/10 of the conventional of the weight of a conventional stator for the same power rating. Our axial flux PM motors are no different than conventional permanent magnet motors in the sense that both of them require VFD to operate properly. The key differences are that our machine typically has very low stator impedance, which is problematic for conventional VFDs, and we typically operate at higher fundamental frequencies. The motor that I show a couple slides back, the 1/3 horsepower 1800 RPM, operates at a fundamental frequency of 480 Hz. Most of our machines operate at frequencies between 240 and 1000 Hz, which sometimes can be challenging for conventional VFD. So we develop our own variable frequency drive, which is fine-tuned to operate with our motors. It uses silicon carbide MOSFETs as switching devices. They can operate at switching frequencies between 100 and 250 kilohertz with very high efficiency, typically of the order of 97% or higher, which is a good match to the typical efficiency of our motors, which run around 95%. Our drives come with extender vector control. It has a modular construction, which allows to reconfigure the drive to fit inside different housings and integrate them to the motor. They can also be mounted remotely from the motor, depending on the application. And the controls are IoT enabled with customizable IOs. We have a series of analog IOs, software configurable digital IOs, typically use Modbus TCP IP over Internet or Modbus RTU. We do also offer a plug-in module that allows cell phone network connectivity to an LTE-M protocol. These IoT-enabled features allow for remote firmware updates of the drive. And another feature is the drive can be programmed for demand response. One typical feature, the drive can be programmed to reduce the power going into the motor if there are some curtailing on the power available or some other reasons. Now, let me share some test results of prototypes that we have built in the past. Starting with this 1 horsepower, 3600 RPM motor, it weighed 14 pounds, had 9 inches diameter, 2.5 inches long. To give a sense of scale, we put it side by side with a 1 horsepower, 3600 RPM induction motor, and you can see that ours is about 1/3 of the size and 1/3 of the weight. We tested this motor against the conventional machine using a off-the-shelf drive. So we measured the efficiency of the motor alone was 90.7%. For comparison, IE4 efficiency specification for a 1 horsepower 3600 RPM machine is 83.5%. We also measured the temperature rise at full load was 52.9 degrees Celsius, well within the expectation. This machine was built for a delta T of 80 degrees Celsius. Now moving on to a 5 horsepower prototype that we built about a year and a half ago. This was also 3600 RPM. This machine actually had an VFD integrated in the same housing, weighing 45 pounds, 14 inches diameter and 6 inches long, used IGBTs for switching devices. Here shows the same motor mounted on a plenum fan. We measured the efficiency of the motor and VFD, and the result was 86.2%. We also measured the delta T at full load for both the motor and IGBTs. The motor was 56.3 degrees Celsius, and the IGBTs, the delta T was 52.3 degrees Celsius. This motor was also designed for a delta T of 80 degrees Celsius. Now let's explore some applications for our technology. One of the first areas we investigated was the use of our motors in plenum fans, like the one shown in this picture. These plenum fans are widely used in the HVAC industry, and we also looked into cooling pumps and compressors for chillers. Industrial machinery, one interesting application for our machines are vertical pumps. Our motors are much lighter than conventional machines and much shorter, which offers some interesting advantages in the design of the structure that supports the motor and the pump. We also looked into compressor applications, and we have had discussions with customers about using our machines in power generation. Aerospace is an interesting area for electrification. We have had discussions with companies that are interested in using our motors in drones, aircraft propulsion, and auxiliary motors for aircraft. The lightweight and small volume of our machines is very attractive in these applications. Likewise, in automotive industry, the small size and lightweight is very interesting for hybrid assist, vehicle propulsion, and auxiliary motors for vehicles. We also have had discussions with companies in the appliance space for applications such as vacuum cleaners, like the little motor shown in this picture is a proposed motor for a vacuum cleaner. It runs at 110,000 RPM. We also looked into applications such as dryers and pumps used in appliances. Now let me share with you the next steps of our product development. We just finished the design of our 10 and 15 horsepower motors, which both run at 1800 RPM, 540 Hertz fundamental frequency, and they share the same frame, which is about 20.5 inches diameter, 10.2 inches long, which includes the VFD compartment. The total weight of this machine, including the VFD, is expected to be around 80 pounds. The housing is IP54, IP55 construction, and we just finished the characterization of the 10 horsepower drive, and here you can see the prototype of the 10 horsepower motor coupled to our dynamometer, where we characterize the drive design, which uses silicon carbide MOSFETs, and we tested also the digital and analog IOs. The test of these machines is expected to be completed by the end of August. That's all I have for today. Thank you very much for your attention, and please feel free to submit your questions. Have a nice day.